With us now for more is April Lee Tan, Vice President and Head of Research at Call Financial. Good to see you again, April. Welcome to the program.
Good morning, Kathy.
Right. So how should investors position ahead of the central bank policy decision on Thursday?
Well, actually, at this stage, we don't think that the central bank action is that critical anymore. For us, our concern right now actually is valuations of stocks. Although the economy is recovering relative to being fully locked down under the ECQ, we feel that prices have gone up too much, or the rally is too sharp relative to what's happening in the economy.
Right. So what's missing? What sort of catalyst is the market looking for? If not a policy rate cut, is it a fiscal stimulus measure down the road?
Well, I think we need to see signs that economic growth is going to be stronger. And maybe, again, the more signs that a vaccine is on the way or an effective treatment is there. I mean, there have been some news on that end, but it doesn't mean that the vaccine or treatment is going to be completely effective and online as soon as possible, sooner rather than later. So I think those are some news that would allow the market to go up even faster, or at least to sustain the recovery that we've seen so far.
Looks like a long road to recovery then, if we're talking about a vaccine and that's still to come by next year.
Well, yes, hopefully. I mean, and if we will have enough such that it will be available in the Philippines at an affordable price for everyone to use.
That's true. You know, I spoke to Governor Diokna moments ago, and he did confirm that none of the missing $2.1 billion of German firm Wirecard entered the Philippine financial system. What effect do you see it having on banking stocks?
Well, that's definitely good news, because I think last Friday, a lot of clients were already, and investors were starting to get worried about that. But the fact that the BSP confirmed that the money didn't even enter the Philippines, and, you know, it was used as a, I don't know, tactic from the launderers maybe to, you know, distract authorities. I think it's good. At least it didn't come in here, so we won't be under investigation, and that should, you know, help boost confidence in our banking sector.
Would you invest in bank stocks now?
You know, I would invest in a lot of stocks in the Philippines, depending on the valuations, because we know that banks and a lot of other companies are going to have a hard time, which is why it is an opportunity to buy them at a cheap price. But if you're going to make me pay high valuations on stocks, then I will not, because I know there's still going to be a lot of problems.
All right. So which other stocks then do you see as clearly benefiting from quarantine to a loosening of restrictions, contributing to valuations?
Well, it's still the same group. We still have, say, the telcos and some consumer essential producers like canned goods and groceries. The trend is still there, because a lot of the others that will be affected have rallied quite a bit. And we feel that, you know, maybe it is actually a good opportunity to take some money off the table, or to take some profits and wait for prices to go down. Once we maybe come out with second quarter earnings and the companies give us better guidance, so things like that.
So between now and the guidance, what are you recommending investors in terms of tactical strategy?
Well, I think at this stage, the market is strong, so, and fundamentals are not there. I mean, it's not only in the Philippines, but all over the world. But then maybe fundamental analysis is not the right tool to use at this stage. Maybe technical analysis is a better tool. So for people who continue to trade the market, I think you have to make sure to follow the rules based on technical analysis. If you break certain trends or show some signs of weakness based on technical indicators, then maybe you should be sure to lock in your profits, because fundamentals aren't there to support the strength of the market at this stage.
Yeah, no better time to learn the technicals of the markets. April, thank you so much for the analysis. You keep well. Have a great weekend.
Thank you.
Yeah, April Litan of Call Financial.